Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2422. Can you make a change here and have it show up over there, or change it over there and have it show up here? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Subash. He was watching Lincoln transpose, and he noted that following the steps in the podcast using the transpose function, you can't update something here. All right, that's an error, a spill error, if you have dynamic arrays, or you can't change part of an array in older versions of Excel. And he said, is there a way that if I make any changes in the source, it reflects in the result cells? Well, that always works, of course. No worries there. But then the really hard three words, and vice versa. That means Subash wants to be able to change things here and have it reflect up there. That's not the way Excel works, but it turns out there's a way to do it. You have to be very careful to follow all eight of these steps. If you don't follow all eight of these steps, it's not going to work. Most Excel files are saved as XLSX. You have to save it as XLSM. If you don't do that, you can't do it. And then Alt-T for Tom, M for Mary, S for Sam. That gets you to the Trust Center and Macro settings. Usually it's set up here to disable without notification. You need to move it down to the second one. So that way you can run macros. It'll tell you every time. And you say, yes, I wrote this macro, I'll enable it. All right, and then take your original data here. We're going to copy. We're not going to do the thing in this podcast. We're just going to do a paste special and transpose. All right, so that just creates a picture of the data. It's not live. If I change something here, it won't change in the other place yet. All right, then we're going to switch over to VBA, so that's Alt-F11. That means that you're running Windows or you're running a Mac. This is not going to work in Excel Online, Excel on the phone, Excel on Android, Excel on Commodore 64. In VBA, you may not see the Project Explorer, so you want to come up here to View, Project Explorer, find the workbook you're working on, find the sheet that you're working on, right-click and view code, and you get this big blank area over here. Two drop-downs. First drop-down, choose worksheet, and then they choose selection change. That's not the one you want. Go to the second drop-down and say change. This is a tiny little macro that runs every time that you're going to change a cell. All right, now I'll paste this code down in the YouTube description below. You're going to copy from there and paste to here. All right, so every time that someone makes a change to this worksheet, I'm going to set up a variable called mirror cell, and I'm going to set it equal to false. And then target, that's passed to Excel. That's the thing they just changed, and I want to see what cell did they just change. And in this case, your worksheet's going to definitely be different, so you're going to have to edit this. If they change D3 and you need the dollar signs there, then the cell that wants to reflect the same thing as D3 is B7. I'm going to switch back to Excel, and we'll look at that. So if they change D3, I want the same change to appear here in B7. All right, and then the next thing will be if they change E3, I want that to appear in B8. Now look, for all of this to work, that means that no one is going to insert cells or anything like that. All right, that took me 5 minutes. I only have 10 cells. If you have 100 cells, it's going to take a little bit longer. What this code says is check to see what just changed. If it was D3, then we're going to mirror it in B7. If it was E3, we're going to mirror it in B8, and so on, going both one way and then the other. And then down here, if the mirror cell is still equal to false, that means they changed some other cell, we just exit the subroutine. Otherwise, we turn off the event handlers temporarily and then change the mirror cell to be the value that was just typed and then turn the event handlers back on. Super important that you do those steps. All right, so here we are. Let's come back and we'll test it, all right? And I should be able to type something up here. So for banana, I'll type 100 and it appears there. I can come down here and say no, change it to 200 and it appears up there. If I type something else out here, 123, no change, nothing runs. So I'm free to change anything else in the spreadsheet, but when I change anything here, it will appear in the first place. All right, so while Excel doesn't normally offer that, if you change it here, it'll show up there, or change it there, it'll show up here. Using this VBA, very limited specific case, you can make it happen. To learn more about VBA, check out this book, Excel, VBA, and Macros. There's an edition for 2016, 2019, I think every edition going back to 2003. If you like these videos, please down below like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, I want to thank Subhash for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.